Yeah. Makes me happy. Oh. Oh, Krishnaya namah. Om Sri Govindaya namah. Again. Om Namo Narayanaya Poshpatihan Amritopasaranasi. Amritopasaranasi Amritapitanasi. Om Namo Narayanaya Sri Govindaya. Om Sri Keshavaya Poshpatihan Amritopasaranasi Amritapitanasi. Dari juga baik Krishnaya Vasudevaya Devaki Vandanaya Krishnaya Nama Narayanaya Om Sri Govindaya Vasudevaya Amritopasaranasi Amritapitanasi.
Sound check one. Ek baar bolo Sri Krishna Chand Bhagwan ki jai, Sri Umapati Mahadeva ki jai. My dear friends, could we all please stand as we join in prayer? Today in this village, in this home, in this family, in this community, is a very sad day to lose a pillar of the community. As I invite you to pray, remembering that it is the soul that we focus our prayer. Because as Bhagavad Gita reminds us, na jayate mrita va kadachita nayam bhutva bhava ajo nityam shashonam purane na hanyate hanyamane sharire, that we are not the body, but we are the soul. And that soul is a divine spark of God. This is why we use the word namaste, meaning that I recognize divinity in each. Today as we pray, my dear friends, we pray for the soul of our dear Rosie, who has lived her life for the community, for the village, for the area, and for her family. And having lost such a dynamic individual is indeed a great loss. So let us pray and ask God to bless her soul, to guide and protect that soul, to grant that soul your divine grace. Hari Om Apavitra Pavitrava Sarvashtanga Topiva Yasmareti Punrikangshe Sabhyantara Suchi Namaha Namo Narayane Govindaye Paramatmane Namo Namam Yang Brahma Varuninda Rudra Maruta Stunwanta Divya Stavere Vede Sangha Padakrama Upanishadai Gayanti Yam Samagha Hari Om Dhyana Vashtita Targatena Manusa Pashanti Yam Yogino Yasyang Tang Navido Sura Surgana Deva Yatashmai Namo Namam He Ramam Purushottamam Narhare Narayanam Keshava Govinda Garadhuja Gunanidhe Damodara Madhava He Krishna Kamalapate Yadupate Sitapate Sripate Vaikundhadi Pate Characharpate Lakshmi Pate Pahimam Rama Rameti Rameti Rame Rame Manorame Shahasranama Tatulyam Rama Nama Varanane Ramaye Ramachandraye Ramachandraye Vedase Raghunathaye Nathaye Sitaye Pate Nama Om Vasudevam Sutam Devam Kamsachandvaramardhanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Vande Jagatguru Om Manadhino Dhane Deva Sankachakra Gadadhara Akshapunarikangsham Pretamokshapuruho Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Sri Vishnur 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 Adsri Brahmano Ahnidvitir Prajshri Svetvara Kalpe Bhai Vashmantare Ashtavinshatame Kalyuge Kalipatam Charni Trinda Desha Ruka Nagra Tatsathari Mukhanam Tatsathari Hiyom Emilia Sukara Nam Jaj Prija Jajmana Sahi Om Namo Hiranya Garva Garvastam Hema Bijam Bibhavaso Yam Dwari Mahaghore Andheyatamase Abrite Tatrava Loka Nartham Dipoyam Pratishtatam Om Adhyamukha Gotrasya Mukha Pritasya Mritakshani Shavang Nimit Narayanaya Govindaya Namo Namam Say Om Sri Krishna Arpan. Offer the flowers and everything right here. And everybody put your flowers next to his going down the road. Om Namo Brahmane Nama. Take water, like I did, sprinkle. Om Shavang Nimit. Mritaksane Shavang Nimit Maya Dete Tatsat Hari Om. Krishna Eva Sudevaya Devaki Nandanaya Cha. Nanda Gopakumaraya Govindaya Namo Namam. He Ramam Purushottamam Narhare Narayanam Keshava Om Ritakstani Shavang Nimit Namaha. Now you put your ring finger, stand up here. And from the thing, all the touch hands, eh? Om Namo
Stand up here?
Yeah. Dip it properly now. Now dip more, dip more. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Right, good. Find the two airs. Namostate. Just put it on the cloth, it doesn't matter. On both sides, under the chin. Om Sri Chandanam Maya Deyate Upatishtam Tatsat Hari Hyom. By the flowers. That's where the hand's supposed to be, right there. Right, and right, listen to me. Right here, you do five times and then slowly continue spraying right around. All the touch hands, eh? Walk with them. While the perfume is being offered, I'd ask that we all join in a short bhajan. Jaya Krishna Hare, Sri Krishna Hare, Dukhiyon ko dukh dur kare, Jai 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 Krishna Hare, O Jaya Krishna Hare, Sri Krishna Hare, Dukhiyo ko dukha. Five times. Jai 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 Krishna Hare. Jab charo taraf andhiyara ho, Asha ka dur kinara ho. Jab charo taraf andhiyara ho, Ashaka dura kinara ho aur koi na kevan wala ho fir to hi bera par karo jai 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 krishna hare jai krishna hare sri krishna hare dukhiyon ko dukh dur one more Jai 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 Krishna Hare the Tarya with the RT. It have a DI in it? The Thai one with a DI in it inside. Brindavan Bihari Lal Ki Jai. Thank you very much. Please take your seats.
Namo Narayana, Ayatana, Jaya Namaste, Krishnaya
Nathinodhane Deva. Nathinodhane Deva Sankha Chakradara. Paksha Pundari Kamsham Sveta Moksha Purva Krishna Krishna Kripalutam. Gatir Nagatir Bhava Sansara. Om Yam Dwari Mahatma.
Bihari Lala Ki Jai, Sri Umapati Mahadeva Ki Jai. With your permission, my dear friends, I would sit down. When you're getting old, that's how it is. Today, we need to reflect on what life is. I have known Rosie for many, 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 many years. And she's always pleasant and jolly and friendly and happy and makes everybody comfortable and happy around them. And this is a very good trait, a very good quality. My dear friends, the clock is ticking for us all. People are dying left, right, and center. Every day, there's so many people are dying. Besides the COVID, under natural circumstances. But when somebody die, it is for us to rethink our direction of life. We need to understand, my dear friends, what is our mission, what is our purpose, what is our relevance in this life. Shocking and surprising to say that the vast majority of humanity do not really understand the mission, the purpose, the priority of life. In the Ramayana, we are reminded, Bare Bhagya Manushatana Pawa, that this human existence, and I want you to understand the value of this human existence, and understand we have a limited window of opportunity to achieve that purpose of our existence. We as human beings, my dear friends, we are the highest in the entire creation. We as human beings, we are the only ones who are permitted and privileged to talk to God. Understand what I'm saying? We as human beings are the only ones permitted and privileged to talk to God. That, my dear friends, is one of the priorities of this life. But when we get here, we get what you call distracted, derailed in house and land and wife and husband and children and car and money and job and so many different issues that we miss the objectives, the sole primary purpose of our existence is to bring the soul into oneness with God. The United Nations did a survey, and 83% of the world population don't have time for God. And this is so, so sad. It means that we have an 83% failure rate as a human being. 83% of us, we don't have time for God. Because what we're doing, we're searching for happiness. And we hinge our happiness in the material world. We say we got a house, we're gonna be happy, we got a child, we got happy, we got a husband, a wife. My dear friends, I want you to understand today, use this death today as a wake-up call to us all to rethink the direction of your life, the purpose of your life, and use that scripture as the yardstick to guide you in your spiritual development. You are all, we are all on a spiritual journey, a pilgrimage to bring the soul into oneness with God. But we spend so much of our time in search of happiness and fulfillment. And I'll tell you, the sad reality is nothing in this material world could bring you happiness. Nothing in this world can bring you happiness. The only true happiness is when you are able to communicate with the Master on a one-to-one. That is true happiness. Everything else is what is called momentary pleasure. And there is a vast difference between momentary pleasure and true happiness. First of all, I want you to understand the definition of happiness. Happiness is a state of mind, a state of consciousness, a state of awareness that brings inner peace within. What happens when we come in this world and we take our first breath, we start that search for happiness. And that search ends when we take our final breath. Until we learn to unconditionally devote ourselves to God, that is the true sense of happiness. That's the only source of happiness. My dear friends, nobody is leaving this world unless we pass through this channel of death. Nobody is going to leave here alive. Nobody here could picture themselves lying down in a coffin and people crying over them and offering light and flowers and prayers. Nobody could picture you. Shut that part out of your existence, out of your mind. Najayati mrtva kadachita nayam bhuta jonicham shishonam purane nahanyate hanyamane sharire. Bhagavad Gita chapter 2 verse 20 reminds us that we all have to die. You could be how rich, how powerful, how beautiful, how whatever. Ek din hame bhi jana hai. That bhajan. Ek din hame bhi jana hai. Ek din hame bhi jana hai. Jag chala jata hai sara iska. Kaun thikana hai, ek din hame bhi jana hai. We all have to leave this world one day, my dear friends. Everything that we do is based on karma. Every single thing that we do, every moment of our existence. Because we are constantly performing actions. And those actions that we perform are categorized, are cataloged, are classified as good or bad. And the more good we do, the greater our spiritual existence. And the more wicked and bad and ignorant and violent things we do, the more. You see, the category good and bad, that is the battlefield. Bhagavad Gita, Dharma Chetre, Kurukshetre, that we are all on this battlefield. God on one side and Satan on one side. And whichever one we feed, that is the one that will predominate in your life. If you're always polite and kind and humble and respectful and charitable and polite, then your life is all, because people's heart will bless you. But if you are ignorant and arrogant, you might have a little place, a little position, a little authority, a little, and you feel that you could use a little tin god and you could do whatever you want. Ravan, in the Ramayana, we had two characters, Ram and Ravan. Wherever Ram went, he brought happiness. He brought comfort. He brought peace to people. He brought love to people. And the people blessed him. Ravan, the same Ramayana, Ravan, whenever Ravan went, he brought tears to people's eyes. Ravan had no respect for anybody, sister, mother, daughter, wife, rights, property, nothing. Anything come to his mind, he would do. And the evil things that he did caused not only to destroy himself, but he destroyed his entire family, his entire kingdom. And that is a lesson for us in the Ramayana, that try to do good. You might have a little authority, a little position, a little fame, a little finance, a little whatever. Be humble about it. Be simple about it. Be kind, be polite, be charitable. Because this is what will take us forward. But with ignorance and arrogance and violence and... when you get to realize what this life is all about, your whole attitude changes. It brings you down from the high horse. Then you realize that one day I have to go and let me do the goods that I can do so that in my hereafter I'll have a better existence. You see, my dear friends, people's tears is very, very destructive. When you do bad and people tears, not physical tears, but the inner tears, the emotional tears, when that fall on you. There's a bhajan that says, Koi laka kare chaturai karamaka lekhamite nare bhai karamaka lekhamite nare bhai. My dear friends, everything is hinged on karma. Everything is hinged on karma. And when you do good things, the receiver of that good things blesses you from the heart. And when you do wicked and evil and bad and the tears, you can't get away from that, my dear friends. You could get away from the law, you could get away from the owner, from the police, from your teacher, from your boss, but you cannot get away from karma. Karma pradhana vishwakaraka. That law of karma is not a Hindu law, that is a universal law. That is a universal law, my dear friends. That everything that you do, you have to pay for it. And if you don't pay for it in this life cycle, when you die and you're reborn again, you still have to continue paying until you wipe off that karma, bad karma. This explains why, for instance, a child might be born in Valsain, and that child don't even have to pick up the plate from the table to carry in the sink. And another child might be born in another home. 3, 4, 5 years, they had to look for a paint pan and go and dig up in garbage to get something to eat. Why would a child be born sickly or retarded? Or it is an explanation of the karma of your past. And you see, when you understand that and things happening with you, you realize where that action coming from. That knowledge that, okay, I am going through this process because of my past actions that I have performed. Maybe not cognizant of the present life, but in your past lives, you may have committed these. And it has to be fulfilled. There is no escape. There is no escape. There is no getting away from that, my dear friends. Life is very short. People are not realizing what this life is all about, your full potential. You hinge your happiness that is in elusive objects. For instance, you say, you know, Baba, if I win the lottery, I will be happy. The more money you have, the more headache you have. You win the lottery, you can't sit down comfortable like you are sitting here. You have to be looking back to see when somebody comes with a gun to shoot you. You say, Baba, if I get a brand new car, I'll be happy. You get a brand new car, you're going down the road, it's shut down, or somebody bonks it, the same happiness turns to unhappiness. Anything that you could think about in the world, my dear friends, brings with it a certain degree of momentary pleasure, but not happiness. Momentary pleasure is different from happiness. Happiness, we pin and hope and plan our happiness in the material world. It don't work. It cannot work. It's not meant to work. True happiness. In the Ramayana, we have a very old lady called Sayuri. Sayuri was from a wild tribe. She couldn't read and write. She was from a tribal group in the forest, never went to school, but she had love for God. She had love for God. She understood her purpose in life, and she devoted and dedicated her entire life to serving God. The ashram that she was attached to, when the guru of the ashram was about to expire, he said, Sayuri, continue doing what you are doing. One day the Lord will come to visit you, and be prepared. And that be prepared, my dear friends, applies to us all. Are we preparing ourselves for this eventuality? Because out there, somewhere there is already a log, a tree, a plant to build your coffin. Isn't that scary? It's frightening. It already have a board to build your coffin. So that is a wake-up call to us all to think and rethink our purpose and direction and priority of life. Sayuri dedicated herself to God. And when the Bhagavan Sri Ram, when the Lord came to visit her, according to the words of the Guru, the first question she asked is, Prabhu, kahi bidhi astuti karahu tumhari? She said that, Lord, tell me, where is this whole thing about God and prayer and praying and religion? And I don't understand anything because I am a wild tribe person. I can't read and write. I don't know mantras. I don't know prayers. I don't know. Tell me, Lord, what is this whole thing about religion and scriptures and prayers and praying? The Lord said, Sayuri, manahu eka bhakti karanata. That God only understands one language, and that is the language of your heart, of your inner self. God only understands one language, the inner self, when you sit down and pray. We as human beings are the only ones who have that opportunity and privilege to talk to God. Never, never, ever neglect that opportunity, my dear friends. The vast majority of them, they remember God when they pong their finger, they go, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, and when the pain pass, they take God and push him in the back pocket again and forget about God until they pong their finger again. No, this is the relationship that we cultivate and we develop with God. A relationship of convenience, right? Only when we want something, we have exam or we have an operation or we have some sickness and we pray and pray and pray. And when we done, overcome our sickness or we pass our exam, forget God again until we want something else done. We treat God like Cinderella stepsister, which is so sad, which is so unfortunate. We should be aware and conscious of our priority, of our duty, of our responsibility. This human life that we have, my dear friends, is our responsibility. A responsibility for us to manage and govern our lives using our scripture as the guideline. But sometimes we spend 30, 40, 50, 70 years and we even learn one prayer, one mantra. Very often people say, well, you have your guru mantra, or you recite your guru mantra all the time. But Baba, I forget my guru mantra. You see, people figure if they spend some time in prayer, they will get poor. If they spend 5 minutes in prayer, there's too much investment. But they will spend 2, 3 hours, 5 hours in a river lime carnival around the corner. They will spend the whole night partying and fetting. But to spend 5 minutes in prayer. They will spend $200-$300 in the river lime, buying all the things that they need. But to buy a little bottle of oil to light a dia, boy, that would be too expensive. I can't afford that, you know. So my dear friends, what is our priority? Where is our priority? Where is our knowledge, our common sense, our intellect? Right? We become so lackadaisical. We become so lackadaisical in our journey, in our objective. And this is why I keep re-emphasizing, because I see the failure of humanity. In closing, I will say this, that the human race, and I want you to understand what I'm saying, value what I'm saying. The human race, physically, have been the sickliest and the weakest we have ever been. The human race is the sickliest and weakest we have ever been physically. Now we have 5-year-old wearing glasses. A 5-year-old with diabetes and all kind of thing. So physically we are the weakest. Mentally we are the weakest. Now look, the other day I went to buy something in a store in Arima, and it was 2 items at $10 each. And the cashier, looking all on the counter for a calculator to add. All are laughing, that's true. To add $10 and $10. Someone say, hey, where's your phone number? Wait. I'll give him a phone number. And then you look for the phone, oh, my number is so and so. It happens all the time. We are not using our brains, my dear friends. This is our brains now. Everything is this. This is addictive. It is destroying our mental capacity and capability. Long time, I mean, people ask 10, 12, 15, 20 phone numbers and they rattle it off that. Now, where's your mother's phone number again? Baba, me, you know, I have to check my phone. So instead of using their brains, they're using the AI. And it's getting worse, eh? I'll tell you why. All these studies with O levels and A levels and PhD and LLB and thing would be of no use, because every question that you need, the answers will be right here. So you don't need to study. You need to learn how to press button and get the answers. And if you don't use it, you lose it. And that is what is happening. People are losing their memory. They don't have the intelligence anymore. It's gone to the machine. So physically, we are the lowest and the weakest. Mentally, we are the lowest and the weakest we have ever been. And spiritually, we are the weakest. As a child growing up, I remember people will sit down and pray. Now to offer a liter of water, they mumble and they grumble and they humble and they stumble and they fumble to offer a liter of water. That costs nothing. To sit down and spend 5-10 minutes in prayer, light a dia. You see, prayer and praying is a mystery. Science cannot explain the mystery of prayer and praying. So we have to spend more time in genuine prayer. And religion is exploiting to the people to the max, because of they realize that the human mind is craving, grieving, crying out for spirituality. And these religions are milking them, are exploiting them to the max. Because of that need. But Bhagavad Gita tells you, patram pushpam phalam toyam yume bhaktya prachati. That you pray for yourself, offer flowers. Today's Valentine's Day. Truckloads and truckloads of flowers are being distributed all over. But you offer one flowers to your God? Because the flowers is a symbol of love. You see the flowers that Rosie has wrong, huh? That is the love that the children has for her. Flowers is the symbol of beauty, of fragrance, of love, of all the things good. And this is why Bhagavad Gita says, patram pushpam phalam toyam. That offer a leaf, a flowers, a fruit, or even a drop of water and pray. And if you do that, nobody will exploit you. Nobody going to milk you. Nobody going to... So many families are being destroyed with the division and the rules and policies of religions, that wife and husband are talking to each other because of different faith and beliefs, and two neighbors vex with each other because they don't. This is craziness, my dear friends. This is absolute craziness. God is within you. This is why in the opening prayers I said that God is the divine spark within you. Awaken that divine spark. Develop that divine spark. So spiritually, man is the weakest they have ever been. So mentally, physically, and spiritually, you are going down a slippery slope. Sad, isn't it? In the Ramayana, in Kali Yuga Mahima, it says that at the height of Kali Yuga, man will take bamboo rod to pick baigan. And I see that happening already. Yes? Man is doing themselves a tremendous, 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 tremendous bad. A lot of the things that are happening in our life is based on our diet. The World Health Organization now admitting that meat is not good for you. But our scriptures 5,000 years ago said that meat is not good for you. And physically and mentally and spiritually, it's destroying you. The World Health Organization now admitting that meat is destructive. The scriptures say that when you eat the animal, you start thinking like, because you absorb the animal DNA. And that animal DNA that you absorb confuses your own DNA. And then you can't think and you can't rationalize and you can't decide properly. You start lowering your thinking pattern to the level of the animal. That's physically. Mentally, you start behaving and acting and thinking like the animal. And spiritually, it's called a cha, the qualities of the animal you absorb. So, my dear friends, we are doing ourselves a great injustice, a disservice, by falling victim to the tantalizing advertisement that you must have this KFC or this Royal Castle or this whatever, and you're going for it, you become falling a victim, that is the bait, and you are going downhill, downhill, downhill. Eating the animal, you're destroying your physical, you're destroying your mental, you're destroying your spiritual self. 5,000 years ago, Hinduism have been advising you. All the sickness that's going around now, if you do a proper analysis, not only COVID, but all the sickness from the beginning of time is hinged to the dietary practices of the animals that we are eating. My dear friends, the animal have as much rights to exist on this planet Earth as you have. Not because you're stronger, smarter, that you'll kill all of them and eat them. You know, just behind my house, it had two deer living, and they've been living for quite a while. And just last year, March month, early in the morning, I hear gunshots, boom, boom, boom. Somebody killed the deer, eat it. And then our children, our grandchildren would never have the opportunity to see a Guti or a Dea or a Gona walking around in the premises, because everything is killed and eaten. And that is so sad. So, so, so sad, my dear friends. So, my little message for you this morning, my dear friends, is that use the death of this family of Rosie to be a wake-up call to us all, that we have a ticking clock. Our time is getting shorter and shorter. Every day, every step, every stage, every minute, every week, we are closer to our date with death. And if we are closer with our date with death, then we need to wake up and do what we have come here to do. And that is bring your soul, your spirit, your Atma into one with Paramatma. My dear friends, in closing, I'd ask that we all please stand and put hands together once again and pray that, Bhagwan, today, Lord, we pray that you bless the soul of Rosie, to the children, to the families and nieces and nephews. We pray, God, that you give them strength and courage to be a guide and take our flowers, or the five of them. Take for flowers. We pray, Bhagwan, that you bless and protect those who have survived, and guide and bless them. Give them strength and courage. Also, my dear friends, I ask you to offer a word of prayer in memory of your loved ones who have come before you, who have worked and built and contributed and sacrificed to have you where you are today. Because of their input, you are where you are. And today you ask God to bless their souls for the love and the care and the protection and the guidance and the advice that they have given to you. Pray for them. Hari Om Namo Narayanaya Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Krishnaya Govindaya Keshavaya Namo Namam. Hari Om Anadhinodhane Deva Sankha Chakra Gadadhara Aksha Pundarikangsham Preta Moksha Prudabhava Om Krishna Krishna Kripalontan Gatirna Gatirbhava Sansaragn Prasiddha Purushottamam He Ramam Purushottamam Narhare Narayanam Keshava Govinda Garudhuja Guna Nidhe Damodara Ramadhava He Krishna Kamalapate Yurupate Sitapate Sripate Vaikuntari Pate Characharpate Lakshmi Pate Pahimam Om Ayodhya Mathura Maya Kashi Kanchanati Puri Dwarati Sapta Mokshadayakam Sapta Dhamma Surabhava He Ramam Purushottamam Narhare Narayanam Keshava Govinda Garudhuja Guna Nidhe Damodara Ramadhava He Krishna Kamalapate Yudupate Sitapate Sripate Vaikuntari Pate Characharpate Lakshmi Pate Pahimam Ram Nam Satya Hai Yehi Sab Ki Gati Hai Krishna Chand Bhagwana Ki Jai. Alright, offer your flowers on this side. Please take your seats. Thank you very much. At this time, my dear friends, I invite, if anybody wish to come and say a few words, I think Cherry wanted to say a few words, if I could find her. Or if anybody wish to come and say a few words, the floor is open. If you invite, you're invited to, right, all good song, to express your sentiments. While I invite, come Trailer, come and offer flowers.
Let me offer a little word.
Sure.
Right before morning.
Morning.
Yeah, oh Lord, the song of Rosie calls. Yeah, oh Lord, and have mercy. Her soul is longing for the glory of you. Oh, yeah, oh Lord, and I'm searching your future then. I believe in the children for the future. You all teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside of them. Give them a sense of pride to make things easier. You make the children laughter so it could remind you how you used to be. Everybody looking for a hero. These children need someone to look up to. They never find anyone who can fulfill the need. I find a way, Papa, so I try to depend on me. I decided long ago never to walk in anybody's shadow. And if I fail, I succeed. I was living in my belief, but no matter what they take from you, they can't take away your dignity. Because the greatest, I still love of all, is happening to me. I found the greatest love of all inside of me. The greatest love of all. Listen up, people. It's so easy to achieve. You are learning to love yourself. And it is the greatest love of all. So Jesus on the way line, you tell him what you want. You tell him what you want. Tell him what you want. Jesus on the way side, tell him what you want. You tell him what you want right now. If you want pardon, if you want peace, if you want pardon, you bow down on Jesus' knee. So this morning, somebody passing by. This morning, Jesus is passing by. God the Father and God the Son, it was God the Holy Spirit. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Now I put my Bible in front of this door. Satan, you can't enter here. I put my Jesus inside of this funeral. Satan, you can't enter here. And I put my Jesus inside of this door. So this morning, Jesus is passing by. God bless you.
Thank you very much, sir. Well said.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, go ahead. Take flowers, perfume, Arti. Take the rose. Give her the rose. Take the rose. No, just put the flowers on bow. So, my dear friends, you see, I'll give you a little example. People are fighting over religion that my God is bigger than your God and your God is bigger, is not God and all kind of thing. But I'll give you an example. I am standing in front of you here as a pundit because I'm portraying the role of a pundit. But when I go home, I put on a tiara pants and a tall boots and a wool hat. The same pundit now turn a farmer. Right? And when I jump in my car and I'm going down to the cremation site as a driver, it's the same pundit. Understand where I'm coming from. Right? When I stop by the parlor to buy a sweet drink, I become a customer. Right? When I go home, I become daddy to the children. I'm the same one person. So it's one God portraying different roles and functions called by different names. So all this fighting about I is this and I is that and you is that and that's total garbage. Look, somebody clapping me in the back there because they acknowledge the logic in what I am saying. So my dear friends, I invite you at this time and I thank you for your attention and for the opportunity to address you. Anybody who wish to come and perform arati, do so now. Thank you very much. She has done today, we reflect upon that and sit around, Jai Krishna. And not only remember, but our hearts bless her for the kindness and for the goodness that she has done. And it applies to us all across the board, my dear friends, that we are here for a short time. Do whatever you have to do in terms of goodness, so that goodness should follow you, that goodness should be on your path. So all who wish to come and offer flowers and arati and things could do so now. Thank you. In the program, there's a bhajan that I could invite you to share with me. The first bhajan in the program. Pinjare ke panchi re, tera dard na jaane koi, tera dard na jaane koi. Pinjare ke panchi re, tera dard na jaane koi. Bahar se to khamosh rahe hai, bahar se to khamosh rahe hai. Bheetar bheetar roye re, bheetar bheetar roye re, tera dard na jaane koi, tera dard na jaane koi. कह न सके तो अपनी कहानी तेरी भी पंछी क्या जिंदगानी रे कह न सके तो अपनी कहानी तेरी भी पंछी क्या जिंदगानी रे विधि न तेरी कथा लिखे आंसू में खलमत हो तेरा दर्द न जाने कोई तेरा दर्द न जाने कोई पिंजरे के पंछी रे तेरा दर्द न जाने कोई तेरा दर्द न जाने कोई. That bhajan says that the bird is whistling in the cage. We think that bird is happy, but in that cage that bird is really crying out, that nobody knows the pain and the discomfort and the suffering of that bird in the cage. And this is this true story of us, that we are smiling and laughing and happy, but you don't know what the pain and what the agony and turmoil that we are going through in life. So my dear friends, thank you for your attention and God bless you.
Sita. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Rama, Rama, Hare, Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Rama, Rama, Hare, Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna.
Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Haraya Namah Krishna Yaravaya Namah, Yaravaya Maravaya Keshavaya Namah, Gopal Govindam Srimadusudan Gidiyari Gopinath Madanamohan Shri Chaitanya Nityananda Shri Advaita Sita Hari Guru Vaishnava Bhagavat Gita Hare Haraya Namah Krishna Yaravaya Namah Yaravaya Maravaya Keshavaya Namah Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Stop man, stop on the radio.
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Garavani Prachayane Nirvisesa Sunyavari Paschatyadeshetarini Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Jaya Prabhupada 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 Jaya Prabhupada 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 Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare So Bhagavad Gita says, Manvanava Pumad Bhakto Madhya Shinam Namaskuru Mam Eva Sisi Satyam Te Pati Jane Priyasime. Always think of me, become my devotee, worship me and offer your homage unto me. Thus you would come to me without fail. I promise you this, because you is my very dear friend. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So as the Panditji was saying, we should be praying all the time. There's one person, Bhagavad Gita says, Yam yam vapi smaram vavam tijayate antikalevaram tam tam evaiti kuntiya sadatat bhava bhavitaha. According to one day to your conscience at the time of death, that is where spirit soul would go. So if you're thinking of Krishna even at the last minute, that is why if we are sick, tulsi water, preaching, hearing Bhagavad Gita, hearing the Ramayana, despite you live a life otherwise, even Sri Valmiki Muni lived a life differently. He was a great personality, but a hunter found him, and he was raised as a thief, a murderer, whatever. And Sri Narad Muni made him the great Sri Valmiki. You stop, man. Let me chant then. No, I go chant when they go in. When you chant, let me chant when they go in.
Thank you very much. Okay. So at this time, my dear friends, I would ask one of the niece, Sherry David, to express her sentiments. Sherry.
Sitaram, and good afternoon, good morning, everybody. I really was supposed to do this eulogy, but at the time, I just lost 4 words right now. Rosie was really a nice person. Rosie loved to cook. Rosie would call me every day. Rosie would call every day. I have to tell her Rosie I'm at work. That didn't stop her from calling me. Even in the hospital, while Debbie was by her bed, Rosie knew it was I who was talking to her. Rosie wanted me to come and look for her. This was Rosie's trick. Rosie called. She said, Sherian, the house on fire. I said, on work. Call fire services, summer. She called my back. She said, I'm still seeing the smoke. I said, ask uncle, I have to walk and check for my comment. I will leave work and come. I couldn't leave work and I called her back. Is everything okay? She said, yeah, but you still need to come because nobody there has seen the smoke. I didn't come, I come the day after. This was Rosie. Rosie say, no longer calling if any mango girl. That is why I call you and tell you that I thought the fire and make you come. All because Rosie love mango. And something about that mango tree, she just always want the mango. Everything Rosie cook, everything Rosie do, Rosie will call me. My mother was sick a few months ago and Rosie would call every day. Rosie wanted a video call to see in the hospital what going on. Rosie live a happy life. Yes, everybody had the good times, the bad times, but Rosie had good times. We had good times together. I share some memories with our children. A couple nights ago, because I've been here with them from the day Rosie died till now. Even every day when we're going to make arrangements, I'd make little jokes to cheer them up, to remind them the things that Rosie would do. Just, that is inevitable. Nobody could face that, but that is reality. We have to face this. Rosie, you'll be missed by many. Fly high. We love you, Rosie. Rest in peace.
Thank you very much. The sentiments expressed by a close relative of the kind of life that Rosie, well, she's give cherry mango and give me pigeon peas. And so many other people would give different things, but it all adds up, not only the pigeon peas or the mango, but the love and the intention on which it was done, with that kind of caring and loving way. And that is the important landmark with Rosie. God bless her. Thank you very much.
I'm going to be singing until you put on the mic. So just put on the mic when you're ready. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Put first and come on the side here. the cloth, foot first, eh? I got a bucket now, you could make me call a little bit.
Step back and...
Look one pull, about
No, you have something here to do. Awesome.